Hey guys! Okay, we're going to start in a second. My board is a little bit wonky. Let's see how we do. Okay, let's see how we do today. So, okay, we've got people popping in the chat. Hello guys, nice to see you. Hello! Right, let's see if I can get a bit more light in here. Okay, right. Yeah, we're doing all right. Not bad. Hello, nice to see you guys. Oh, people popping on the thread. Hello. We've got a really fun session today. We're going to be doing a bit of an adventure. I hope you're going to join me for it. Oh, my goodness. This is our very last session. Well, we've got one more session next week at 9:30 for everyone. But like, this will be our last full key stage 3 and 4 session, and I'm really looking forward to working with you guys today. Right, let me just see if I'm gonna see if I can brighten this up a bit, because it's a bit dark, isn't it? How are you guys doing today? Feel free to say hello if you'd like to. I know we get a few people that like to just tune in and watch, but that's cool. If you want to say hello, feel free to, and I can chat back. Let's see, try that. Let's see how we go. Okay, we're gonna be starting, if it's okay, we're gonna start in just about 1 minute's time. Gonna give a little bit of time people to get on the thread. I can see we've got a few people on YouTube and on Facebook. Fantastic. We'll see how we go. And oh, cool. People saying hello. Hello. Good morning. Hey. Oh, Jack. Nice to have you back. Cool. Wicked. We will start in just 1 minute. I'm going to grab myself a quick drink and we'll get ready. All you'll need today is a pen and a piece of paper. And I'm really looking forward to working with you. Okay, sorry to keep you waiting. Right, let's see how we're doing. Let's move for that. Oh, that's falling apart. Okay. Right. Okay, so this morning, hopefully you guys are all good. Hello, my name is Mark. We've got a few more people here on the chat. So guys, my name is Mark. I'm a poet, I'm a writer. I'm currently writing storybooks as well, which are coming out in a couple of years, I'm excited about. But today we have our last session working together, and we are looking at exploring kind of an ancient tomb. I thought it'd be kind of fun to use the skills we've got so far, see if we can create one coherent little kind of narrative in a few paragraphs. Because when we're writing descriptively, I think one of the things I've noticed in the group so far is that we're very good at doing these separate bits, but threading a story all the way through will really help us kind of gain more marks when we go on to kind of that key stage 4, kind of like paper 1, question 5. So what we're going to do today is, first of all, I'm going to kind of show you a couple of characters that we associate with adventure. So first of all, we've got, this is a bit big, you might recognize this guy. This is like, showing my age a bit, but like when I was growing up, this guy was, this is who I wanted to be, I think, when I grew up. I love this guy. This is Indiana Jones. He's associated with adventure and exploring. We have another example of this I can show you here, which is, here we go as well. This is Lara Croft. It's not the best image of her, But both these characters are doing something very similar. There's also kind of a like Nathan Drake in the Uncharted series of computer games. We've always had a fascination, I think, with this idea of exploring these ancient cultures and these ancient kind of tombs and environments and searching for things. So my question, first of all, is why do you think characters like these go exploring in ancient ruins? Like, what do you think they're trying to get? Why do they want to do what they're doing? When we're writing a piece of descriptive writing, I think it's a good idea to know why that character is there doing what they're doing. So my question to you guys, first of all, is why do these... Oh, I haven't even got it here. So why... So here we go. Why do these characters explore ancient ruins? What's our reason? And you've got like, you know, a minute. I don't even think we need a minute. We've already got one suggestion on the chat from Adam. So why do these characters explore these ancient ruins? What do we think? We've got a suggestion here from Adam. I like it. To find treasure, to uncover mysteries, maybe something to do with their past. Yeah, these are good motivations for characters. And what we're really talking about is motivation, aren't we? Kind of the reasons why a character is going to do something. If we're writing a short piece of descriptive writing, we probably don't have enough time to show everything about a character's life. But we can probably suggest their motivation, like why they want to be where they are. They could be on a quest. Great. Okay, so Jack, my question is another why. Why are they on the quest? Why do people take up quests? So I think that's a great question. In fact, I'm going to reword it, and I'm going to give you a minute to rewrite this down. Why do characters take up quests? Can you think of a list of reasons? I think there's quite a few. I think it's possible to come up with at least, you know, 4 or 5 different reasons. And these things are really important to think about, because if we can stop these things, if we can list these things, we can kind of include them as motivations for our own characters. And they're things that help our character feel believable, right? And it means that we know what a character wants. If we know what a character wants, we know what a character doesn't want, and we know therefore we know what we're rooting for, what they care about. So what do you think? Why do characters take up quests? Okay, so these are great. Cool. Right, I'm all ready now. Sorry about that. That was the key stage 1 and 2 session was it required some costume changes, which is a bit weird. All right, cool. So let's see how we're doing. Great. Your suggestions are phenomenal, by the way. Absolutely brilliant. Oh, great. Okay, we got a great suggestion coming from YouTube as well. Now, guys, if you don't want to comment in the thread, you don't have to. You can kind of think about these things yourselves. But these are really useful things to think about with all of our characters. I'm going to take these off, and we're going to have a look at some of our suggestions. All right, so motivations for characters, reasons they might be in an unusual environment. So we might have to find treasure, to uncover mysteries, something to do with their past. So for Laura, we've got specifics about these characters. It's often linked to her father, isn't it? And she's finding out about her like family history, and she cares about that. And that's really effective. And this is used a lot in computer games, isn't it? Often the character doesn't know about their own past or their family, and they're uncovering that. I've been watching a series called The Umbrella Academy, like series 2 at the moment. I'm really enjoying it. And a lot of, I think, series 1, you've got that character, Vanya, who doesn't understand what's happened to her in the past. And again, she loses her memory in this, which is a little bit repeating the same thing. But a lot of the idea is about trying to, all those characters connect with their fathers or their father and understand what's going on in relation to that. Indiana Jones, you know what? He talks about fame and glory. Like, he actually, he's not totally in it for good reasons. Like, some of the reasons behind it, he wants kind of fame and glory. So you might have to stop evil. Yeah, you might have someone who is really just good and noble, and that might mean that they would behave in certain ways. Maybe it's part of an adventure to find something important. Maybe it's to find a key to their past. Absolutely. They want to find out something more about themselves. Maybe it's a moral goal or to achieve something personally. Harry Potter had a quest to destroy the objects. Yeah, cool. The Horcruxes. Jack. Yeah, he was off to go and sort those things out. Now, you might have someone, it's unlikely, you could have someone exploring for revenge. That can be a reason. So maybe someone, they want to get revenge on someone else, and the item is powerful in some way, and it would give them some kind of power or ability to kind of get their revenge. They might be greedy, right? They might want to go and do what they're doing for money. That's maybe what they're so interested about. They're really kind of like motivated by money, or the kind of the fame or the success of gathering the item. Yeah, absolutely. I agree. And discovering this reason is a way to engage the viewer. Umbrellas is brilliant by giving more and more pieces of the puzzle. Yeah, the Umbrella Academy is some things about it I think could be better sometimes, but I think it's really good at telling these kind of multiple narratives with the different characters and giving us just enough information so that our knowledge progresses while we follow all these different strands. Cool. All right. So the reasons behind behind this are really important. So here's the challenge. I want you to have a character. You are searching for an ancient relic. Okay, you have traveled a long way to do this. This relic is called the Heart of Ubtau. It's a huge, I mean, you don't really know what that means, the Heart of Ubtau. You know that it's quite large, and you know that it's buried somewhere in the jungle, and you are exploring, looking for it. So I want you to make a note somewhere, your reason for searching for the Heart of Ubtau. Your character, why do they want the Heart of Ubtau? Is there a reason? Is it worth a lot of money? Does it give you some kind of power or ability? What is the reason for trying to get the Heart of Ubtau? It's buried deep within the tomb of Ubtau. You don't know, maybe it's a gem. Maybe it's like an actual heart. I don't know. But this is the rare item that you are searching for. So I would like you, I'm going to give you 90 seconds. I'd like to write down why you are so keen to get the Heart of Ubtau. Remember, this is your chance to really kind of put your own spin on things. This is the item we're going for, the Heart of Ubtau. Your explorer, they can be male or female, or they can be trans. I do not mind who your character is at all, but you're going to invent a character now. They want the Heart of Ubtau. They are trekking through the jungle, and we need to know why they want the Heart of Ubtau. So that's the question. Why do they want it? What do you think? What is your reason for looking for the Heart of Ubtau? Now, remember, as we come up with these reasons, the reader is not going to know what these reasons are, right? Like at the very beginning, we've got to feed this information to them. We don't need to know all these details, but certainly the character should know why they want to get hold of it. Oh, nice. Nice suggestions already. Okay. Ooh. Cool suggestions. All right, let's have a look at these. Now, what I love about this is as soon as we get into motivations, it's our chance as a writer to really put our stamp on things. So let's have a look. We've got the Heart of Ubtau. Adam has said, for him, it grants mysterious powers that are unknown to the beholder. Okay, so we don't know what it does yet, but its powers are random. Sometimes it grants armor, swords, and other objects such as potions. Okay, cool. It's like it's a random thing. I'd be interested to know how much of this the character knows. Maybe they don't know much about it, but they just know that it's powerful. It's up to you. My characters want to rekindle a lost love or fix a mistake that they made in the past. Okay, that's a cool idea as well. It makes me think of a computer game series called Braid, where the character Tim is always trying to undo a terrible mistake that he made in the past. That's a cool idea. It can stop a terrible plague from spreading across the world. I like that a lot, Ophelia. I've actually taken this item or this idea a bit from a story setting that actually does have a plague within that story, which is kind of amazing. You kind of came up with that. But yeah, that's a great reason to be getting it. What does the plague do? What's going on in relation to that? It has powers to make everyone love you. Hooray! The heart of Uptown, of course. So the heart and love, that's a really cool idea. And if everyone loves you, you can kind of do whatever you want, right? It's incredibly powerful. Okay, we've got Alder Creek is the character's name. He's a middle-aged man, seeks powers to dominate and conquer the world. Oh, pretty evil. Now, we might want to think of a name for this character, right? That might be how we want to write about them. You can decide today if you're going to write in the third person or in the first person. If you're going to write in the third person, well, we're kind of, an omnipotent narrator. We can view everything. We should probably use the character's name. If we're going to write in the first person using I, that's cool, that's great, but we don't have to worry about the name as much. We've got the Heart of Uptown meant something to me as I felt... Okay, so here we go. In the first person, as a great example from Jack, the Heart of Uptown meant something to me as I felt connected to it somehow. It had a place in my heart as it belonged to my great uncle, who I never got to meet. Okay, so this thing had a chance to bring him back to life, so you can bring your relative back to life for only 3 hours. There were so many things I wanted to do with him, but it could only happen on Halloween. Okay, so this is a bit creepy. This Heart of Uptown for you is kind of like kind of necromancy, like bringing back from the dead, which is kind of like some interesting elements. So in whatever context, this is a very powerful thing. It's a very valuable thing, and it has been hidden for a long, long time, which means that there must be, it must be carefully hidden. There are traps, there are all sorts. And what we are going to do today is we're going to try and write through maybe three paragraphs building towards finding this Heart of Uptown and whether we can get there. All right, and this is going to be a good chance for us to think about our descriptive writing as we're going. So let's, first of all, I think I've got like an image that I kind of picked up. Okay, cool. So we've been exploring. Just give us a picture of the kind of place that we're going. This is the kind of environment above ground. You see that? This is kind of where the Heart of Uptown is. If you think about the kind of the feeling of being in a location like this, think about the different senses. What are the things you might see or hear or smell? What are the kind of how do your skin feel? I know we're very good at kind of featuring kind of sweat on our skin when it gets hot, and I think it is quite hot and quite humid here. This is the kind of environment, and this is the space that you have. Oh, it's taking a while to load. There we go. This is the hole, the kind of tunnel that you've started to go down just on the edge of these ruins. I managed to get that from a little computer game screenshot there. All right. So we are now inside the tunnels underneath this city. And I am going to give you your first writing task, which is going to be... Ooh. Okay, you're in an ancient tomb. Here we go. Guys, I'm sorry about that. That was a bit of a shock being chucked out like that. All right, cool. We should be back up, back with us. People back on the thread. So this is the challenge. Sorry about that. You are in an ancient tomb. Describe how you move. Oh gosh, why is this? Okay, how are we doing? Okay, we should have people popping back on. How are we doing? All right, we'll give it a few seconds. Hello, guys. We're back up. How are we doing? Hopefully, people are popping back on the thread. Oh, cool. I can see people popping in. Hey, no worries, CHBJ, BG. Really, really lovely to have you on board like that. How else are we doing, the rest of us guys? We all here? All right. So here's the challenge. We're back. You are in an ancient tomb. Describe how you move slowly towards the heart of Ubtau looking for traps. All right. Now, bear in mind, this character is an experienced treasure hunter, perhaps, or maybe they're not. It's up to you. But you need to make sure to show that they feel tense and they feel anxious. Hey, how's it going? So I'm going to give you guys 3 minutes for this. We said we liked a 3 minute time. Do you know what? I'm going to give you 3 minutes 20 because I think it's a bit of time. I want you to think about the different senses as you're crawling through looking for things. So the different senses are really, really important. What can we see? What can we hear? What can we smell? What can we touch? How are you building a sense of tension and excitement? Is there a way you can reveal this character's motivation as they're moving? Let's see what we can come up with. Your time starts now. Really sorry for cutting out like that when we did. But let's see how we do. I think you can do this. You're heading through towards the heart of Ubtau. What is happening? What are you finding as you are moving? So, hello, Lucy. Hello, lovely to see you. So what do you think? How would you describe moving towards the heart of Ubtau? You're in an ancient tomb, underground. What would we say? What do you think? And this is your chance to really think about what you would say. We're going through these tunnels, having a little look. We're exploring. What do you think you would say? No, let's put on some adventure music. Oh, nice. We've already got some cool ideas coming in. Well done, guys. Well done for dealing with the disruption. Let's see how we do. Got a minute left. If you want a little image, someone has said they would like a little image. Let's have a little look. There we go. Maybe we've got kind of spaces like this. How creepy if it was still lit. Oh, Lucy, very nice. Okay. Let's have a little look, see how we've done. Now, once again, it doesn't matter if you don't want to share what you've put on here. We'll just see what we've got. And also, if you're completing this after the workshop's been done, hello, thanks for jumping over to the second video of this. Like anything you've completed, if you want to send it to me at the end, I can have a look at it. But otherwise, let's see what we've come up with. So we've got, these are great. So the walls were slimy and my claustrophobia was kicking in fast. Great. So great. Straight away, we've got tension and we get the idea that this character is a little bit out of their depth, which is exciting. We're always rooting for someone that is kind of vulnerable or at risk. I felt as though the floor was crumbling underneath my feet, like a biscuit in my cup of tea. Yeah, great. I like that a lot. I like the simile. I'd love it if we can have like a cup of tea, like back home or something, even some way that we can feel the difference of that cozy world back home and the reality of the crumbling ground underneath you here. But that Jack, that's ace. Oh, how I long for one of them right now. But there's no time for that. I felt in danger and wanted to flee. But look, just look at me. I got this far. It can't be that bad, can it? Great. I like the question at the end. I like a lot of things you're doing here to get this, give this voice personality. I like, look, just look, I think is a really effective little piece of writing. Oh, how, I think is like kind of nice as well. I think I got a real sense of your character coming through in this, Jack. I think you've done a brilliant job there. Well done. So next up, we've got Adam. I slowly, cool, creaked into the tomb. The rocks inside this place were ragged. Cool, I think this is great, just maybe a word instead of was, were ragged, sharp and pointy. The tomb was very narrow and I could hardly see. I began to see a light emitting directly north. I needed the light to guide me to the heart of Abtek. Cool. I like it a lot. I like the light emitting directly north. It's kind of cool. I needed the light to guide me, I think is nice. Be careful. If you've shown what things look like and then you've said, I can't see very much, it's a bit of a confusing to go from like describing seeing things and then saying, but I can't see, and then the light so I can see again. I think that's the only thing I'd say, Adam, but I think those descriptions are ace. Lucy, let's have a look. My feet started to touch the floor. It was dark, so I was shaking. Oh, okay, yeah, because you would be shaking because it's dark and you're scared and nervous. Absolutely. The tunnel. Hey, Darren, nice to see you. The tunnel started off low, so I had to crouch. My torchlight was lighting up glimpses of other passages in front, but I looked down and there were insects crawling around my feet in the slimy floor. Nice. Darren, I really like it a lot. We could maybe, if we've got some of these insects crawling around our feet, might be a good moment to kind of score some points for describing some sounds. Maybe we've got some crunching sounds, popping sounds even, as they're kind of like underfoot. But yeah, I think that's great. I get a real image of how nasty this tunnel is. Yeah, correct, Adam, cool. I know, you're totally fine. I went around the corner and it was all lit up. Okay, yeah, I like it, Lucy. We've got the great all being lit up there. That is fantastic. Okay, so these are really, really good. What we need to do is we need to start getting closer now. Our next paragraph, we are going to see if we can get a bit closer. We're starting, we're close to being able to see it, aren't we? This heart of Ubtow. Ah, there's my overlays. Okay, so my question for you next is, you get closer. So the heart of Ubtow. You can see it at a distance now. What does it look like? I'm just going to put... Okay. Get closer. We can see the heart of Ubtow at a distance. What does it look like? Now, my question as well is, can we include some foreshadowing? So foreshadowing is a complicated word, but it means we give some kind of hint as to something that's about to happen. So foreshadowing is when, for example, we might see a shadow moving across the back wall, or we might see, or we might trip, like hit something, some kind of tripwire that we haven't noticed, and a ball starts rolling in the background behind us as we're getting closer. So this is all, we might just see some kind of thing suspended above us that the character hasn't noticed yet, but the reader does. What can we foreshadow that might be bad. Not happening right now, but maybe we're going to come back to it. It could be bad later on. It can be, you see what you can do. Can you do something small, just in the background somewhere, something whilst this is going on that maybe the character doesn't even notice fully, but is a bit of foreshadowing for things might go a bit wrong. And how are you going to describe this Heart of Uptau? This is from a very, from the distance, right? This is from about, you know, about you know, 50 feet away, a good distance away. What do you think it looks like? So let's have a look. We have got 3 minutes. Your time starts now. What do you think?
Oh gosh. Okay, I'm trying to put on some Tomb Raider music.
Remember, foreshadowing is when we show something that's going to be important later on. We call them Chekhov's guns. So they're normally things that are going to be important later on, things that are going to be either bad or good later on. Probably bad here, right? What do you think? Guys doing really well, by the way. I'm sorry for some of these things being a bit clumsy today, or some of my overlays. Oh, okay, that's okay. You see, so you can see there's a treasure, Lucy. You can see a treasure in the distance. Can you describe the treasure, Lucy? What do you think it would look like? It's called, I'll give you the name of the treasure. It's called the Heart of Uptau. It's a special treasure. Maybe it's a gem. Or maybe it's, I don't know, maybe it's like made of wood. Maybe it, and it's magical. What do you think the Heart of Uptau looks like? It's a magical item or a powerful, important item that you found. So could you describe seeing that item? And maybe you could also describe something creepy happening at the same time. So you see it, but what else could happen? Maybe something could appear from behind you. What could happen behind? That would be really scary, wouldn't it? Or maybe something could happen. What do you think? But how would you describe it? And don't worry if that you find that tricky. Oh, Lucy, very good. Well done.
Right, not long left.
Okay, let's see how we do. Ooh, okay. Let's have a look. Right, guys, you're doing really well. So, lovely. And I know also, I know we have a lot of people who follow this who don't comment. And you guys, you're very welcome to be here. I've loved working with you over the last few weeks. All right, so. Yes, we got, let's have a look at Jack's. This is big, right? We've got a lot here to discuss. So, as we're going through this, all of a sudden, hands leapt out of the floor and I knew I had to run. The vines of the wall were turning into snakes. This was deceiving me. Was I seeing things? No, I wasn't. It didn't matter. I had to run. Blang, blang, blong. Right, now, just for a second, I want to talk about why I like blang, blang, blong. I'm going to just reduce this in size. And I know that's... Oh, I can't. It's such a big piece of writing. I can't. I like blang, blang, blong because I think it's a really, really cool type of... I think it's a really, really cool type of use of an onomatopoeia. Often people use the same kind of words when they're doing onomatopoeia. And I think you've got some like variety there. So I think that's really effective. Well done. That's super cool. So what we've got next is one after the others took their chance to grab me, but I managed to outrun them. I knew that the path ahead would only get harder, but I can get my great uncle's presence pulling me further into the tunnel. And there it was in all its glory, glistening at me. Wait, what was that? It was a basketball above my head. My great uncle's favorite sport. This must have meant something, but what? Really, a basketball above you in the air? That's amazing. All right, cool. That's really original. So what have we got next? We've got Lucy's. So we've got the golden rush of gold around. I like that. And I slowly put my hand around it. I like that. I slowly put my hand around it. You're showing me there that you're very kind of, you're excited, but you're also a bit nervous. I think that's really good. I touched it one bit. And we got Adam. The lights were out of the ordinary. They were oddly shaped. They looked just like hearts. Oh, they started to pump quicker and quicker, emitting a red and ominous light. I like the word ominous. Great vocabulary choice there. When you're doing the GCSE, when you're working on the GCSE, like being a bit ambitious with your language is really, really important. That's a great use there. My heart seemed to react the same. I was in awe and shock at the same exact same time. Is this what fear felt like? Oh, so we know from that you're showing us, but not telling us, that this character has never felt afraid before. It's a really clever way of doing it. I like it. The hearty treasure was encased in the lights. Whee! I think that's ace, Adam. I felt someone following me the whole time. Okay, Lucy, that sounds really creepy. I was blinded by a mysterious glowing red light coming from behind a crumbling arch covered in ivy. The heart. Short sentence for impact to suggest the heart. Nice. You know what you could even do, Ophelia, if you wanted to? You could have that as it's a single paragraph, just being those two words. You could make it its own paragraph and move on to another paragraph if you wanted to. That would be like kind of cool and interesting as well. The light died down to reveal a red gem sat on a marble pedestal in the center of a large empty room. I took a cautious step towards it, past the arch, catching on the ivy as I did so. The arch came crashing down, trapping me in the room. I was stuck. Wow, that's fantastic. Brilliant. Now, can I ask a favor? Can you just, people can still see me? I just want to check that I've not randomly got this kind of cutting out. So if you can still see me and hear me, just let me know in the chat. But those are great. All these things are raising the tension. I can feel the importance of the moment as we're kind of getting to that item. So some of you may have moved past this next stage. If that's the case, feel free to keep on working yourselves on your own piece of writing. Yeah, cool, great. We can all see and hear me. That's great. Okay, so this is going to be it. This is it. Okay, so I've got you the next section. I want you to try this. So then you pick it up. Okay. Oh my goodness. It looks more valuable than what? Think about that simile. See if you can get a simile in. So, oh, do you know what? Oh, you're very welcome, Jack. Oh, do you know what? Darren, let's have a look at this for a second. Yours is great. I could see the glow of red in the distance, but it wasn't heart-shaped. It was triangular. I could almost feel love as I was approaching. That's kind of cool, isn't it? That's kind of interesting. Very, very original. That makes, that. I think anything that we get like this, where we get the special power to this thing, is definitely kind of making me more excited as a reader. I don't know what's going to happen, right? It was suspended on a wire. There were holes in the wall either side of the triangle. The tunnel was filling up with rats as I move forward. Oh, great. So we're starting to foreshadow that things are going to go pretty badly at the same time. So here's the challenge. I want you to write me about picking it up. What does it feel like to touch? What's going on? Oh my goodness, it looks more valuable than, like, what? What can you say about it? What will also go wrong? Okay, so this is the challenge. What is also going to happen that is going to be bad? Now, Ophelia, you've already kind of moved on to this point already, so feel free to continue your story from where you are. If you've kind of moved on to that stage in your piece of writing, that's totally fine. But please think, remember, those who were with me last week, just because things might get fast now, it does not mean that we don't... it does not mean that we forgive up on describing. Make sure, slow down at points. Give me some like powerful description if you can. Remember the different senses. We can move slowly through this. Only a couple of things can happen very, very quickly, and we can describe it really vividly. So let's see what we can come up with. You're doing really, really well. Okay, there we go. So let's see how we have done. I'm really enjoying your stories. Oh, Lucy, I've seen yours. That looks ace. All right, let's have a look at it. Let's see what we've got. I know some people might be finishing their pieces off. That's cool. If you've got a piece, you want to show me what you've got. That's great. Okay, let's have a look. So, then you pick it up. Oh my goodness, it looks more valuable than a gold lamp. My hand started to touch it. I felt a sting. Oh no, what was it? Okay, that's a real tense moment. We've got a sting from on the hand. I picked up the stone, which glowed brighter in my touch. It was a clear red Ben ruby, maybe. It had veins of gold running through it. It looked more valuable than anything you would see in any jewelry shop. Wow, the light suddenly went out. I heard something breathing behind me. I wasn't alone. Cool. I like that I wasn't alone. That feels pretty stressful. Yeah, really, really nice. I like that a lot. Okay. So I leapt for the vines above, seeking and desiring the treasure. I reached towards it and clinging onto the heart, I pulled out my cutlass. Okay, cool. Now, this is great. I would definitely, earlier in the writing maybe, mention the cutlass to one side, because if you've got it mentioned earlier, when you pull it out, we're like, oh yeah, that kind of that Chekhov's gun from before. Remember that you've got it. I tried to cut through its fellow hearts, but my chances were futile. Nice. Every slash felt the same, just as if I'd done nothing. The world seemed to slow down. Suddenly, a strange force emitted from the heart. Ooh, okay, I want you to describe this force. It's really interesting. So powerful. I was flung back by this presence and I smashed into the rocks below. I'd like maybe another sentence to describe this force because it's kind of cool and I'm really interested by it. I kind of want to know, can you see it? Can you feel it? Does it have a sound? What is it like? That's really cool though, I like it. I reached up and pulled out the wire and the glowing triangle dropped into my other hand. I then had a feeling of love wash over me and I knew I couldn't give up this object. It was already dear to me. Oh no, Darren, you found your own precious. We're gonna go a bit Gollum on this. Fantastic, yeah, Ophelia gem, great. Look, that's no worries at all. I picked up the glistening beacon that I longed for since the start. Oh my goodness, it looked more valuable than the Olympic torch. Nice. What was that? The basketball had fallen and opened up. I produced a hologram of him, my great uncle. Oh, she put a hologram out. Hello, my son, this is important. I can't be with you physically, but you should know that I'm always here. He pointed towards my heart and suddenly said, beware, the way out is not the way in which you must find the came. What did he say? I don't know, it was a blur to me. That couldn't become clear. He faded and I leapt to the floor crying, crack. The floor broke and fountains of lava rose up. Oh no, the lava's pretty cool. All right, I heard an evil laugh, didn't know where to turn. I needed his help, he was gone. So there's an evil laugh. Okay, so we've got a lot going on here, Jack. This is great. You might want to have just stage by stage these things. They're cool. Yeah, I think they're really interesting. It's meant to be wait. All right, cool. Don't apologize, Jack. That's great. All right, so you've got all these ideas. All right, so I think we've got the item with us. And I think we need to see and feel get away to try and get away with this now. I'm kind of bit... My signal's not great, is it? Let's see how we go. So, let's have... Here we go. We're trying to get away. We're trying to get away. Can we make it? So we're trying to see if we can get away with the item we do. Remember, we've had our foreshadowing appear. We've shown something bad. Certainly, Adam has got a cutlass now, so he can always use his cutlass because he's mentioned. But what is going to happen is you try and escape now. This is a 3-minute timer. We're going to see what we can come up with. What stage of the writing can we get away? I keep breaking up on YouTube. Yeah, my connection's not great, is it? I'm not sure why it is this morning. Let me just check here. Okay, I might be able to improve it slightly. If I do this. John, I'm going to pause the timer a second. Because I think it's unfair. Okay, how is that? I think we might start to get smoother image. Okay, yeah, I think that's starting to get better. All right, so. Here we go. This is us trying to get away. Let's see how we do. You guys are doing so well, by the way. Okay, Lucy, that's a good question. Okay, so what I wait a minute on this. All right, so the way I would like to start. Here we go. And we're going to make this 2 more minutes. Okay. So you're trying to get away. Can you make it? I ran for my life as... Lucy, try to start like that. I ran for my life as... What happens? What happens around you as you're trying to run for your life? Hopefully that is a little bit faster now. I think we're getting there. That's a little bit better. All right, so what do you think? This is our last one. Guys, you've been really patient today. Who'd have thought that this last session we had together would have so many tech issues? But yeah, you guys have been ace. What you've written is so good. See how we got. We not long left. Now see how you do with this. Bear in mind, it's we want to try and, even though things are moving quickly, we want to make sure we keep using the senses, keep describing things. You've done really well so far with all of these pieces. I definitely think the quality is up on where we were at the start of this. So let's have. Oh, Lucy, I've just seen what you put down. That's cool. So if you guys can finish the line you're on, we'll see how we do. So. I like this. Lucy, we got, I ran for my life as a quick jaguar. I heard more footsteps. Oh no. Yeah, Lucy, that sounds great. Oh, I love it. That's really, really cool. Fantastic. That sounds really, really good. Yeah, how do you come up with a way of making this still seem exciting and engaging, but at the same time not losing one's descriptive writing as we move and we move quickly? What about if we're doing maybe shorter sentences could be interesting? Maybe we're using a variety of punctuation. Let's have a little look, Darren. Let's see what you got here. So we've got the rats were blocking the way out. So I reached into my bag for my jam sandwiches and threw them on the floor in the chamber. The rats started moving out of the tunnel, hunting out my food. Wicked. Now, Darren, I love this. What we could do with this is we can go back to the beginning. We can even talk about the jam sandwiches as we're first exploring the ruins, right? And you're thinking about eating them a bit later on. If we mentioned them earlier on, when we bring them out now, it would be really rewarding for the reader. That's fantastic, though. Threw them on the floor of the chamber. The rats started moving out of the tunnel, hunting for my food. I could see now the way out and ran as fast as I could to the light at the end of the tunnel. Brilliant. This is great. I think one of the things we can do is maybe talking about our muscles, our heart rate, what we're feeling as we're kind of going through this. I think it'd be really interesting as well. So, Adam, let's have a look at this. I really like how you've started this. I tried to escape. Okay. But something grabbed at my foot. Okay, it's an interesting one. I tried to escape. I really like it's a short sentence. But something grabbed at my foot. We could even put, but oh no, something grabbed at my foot. You could put an oh no in there as an exclamation. Might be kind of cool. It felt small and fleshy. There were tiny hearts. So we might need a bit more description on these tiny hearts. Give us a bit of color. Have they got eyes? Like, have they got arms, hands? What do they look like? They started to jump on me one by one. I got rid of a majority of them with just a few swings of my trusty cutlass. Excellent. Now, that every time you mention the cutlass, it's rewarding because you've mentioned it already. And I know that it's there. The more I seemed to destroy, the more they seemed to attack me. My final resort, my last chance was to remove my ancient cutlass. I propulsed it into the air and it managed to hit the direct center. Center of what? That's cool though. The heart started to enlarge. It dropped into my knees and my hands above my head, just begging for a chance to survive. Bang! All right, cool. I like it a lot. Suddenly the heart's imploded. It rained blood. It was not a pretty sight. Yeah, cool. Now, if we can describe that blood, get a word in to describe the blood, I think it'd be really, really effective. I also think, Adam, careful with bang. I think bang is like cool, but as onomatopoeic words go, I think bang is kind of a little bit, it gets used quite a lot. So see if we can try and have like a sound that isn't quite as well known. But that's cool. Your plot there was exciting. There's a lot going on. All right, Jack. What did he mean? I needed something. Maybe I started pressing against the walls around me, which only made matters worse. Balls of poison fell from the ceiling and my shoes were slipping on the icy floor. My hands were getting sweaty. Eventually, I couldn't see a thing. My hand slipped on a piece of netting. The basketball, I suddenly knew what he meant. The basketball needed to go in the net and I would be let free, but it was at the tip top of the lava spout. Okay, cool. Jack, this is great. Be careful with punctuation when we're putting this down. We have to make sure we demarcate effectively so that it's smooth for reader. It doesn't matter now, but like obviously think about that when you're writing it down. But this is cool. But at the tip top of the lava spout, I found a stick and managed to jolt it into the net. I was free! Finally, I felt amazing, but there was something missing. He wasn't here, but I knew deep down he was right in my heart. I didn't need to see him in real life. I knew he would always be with me. Okay, I like the ending. And Jack, like Adam, you both have got really exciting, cool, original, like, narrative ideas. What you've got to do is just make sure if we're describing, if we have like a new thing appear, like a little heart or we've got this basketball, we need to really spend an extra sentence just describing it, making it a vivid image. All right, Ophelia. I turn around to see a creature with wings. A cupid or cherub of some sort, which seemed rather harmless at first glance. But then it suddenly let out an ear-piercing shriek, revealing rows of sharp teeth. Okay, I really like this. I like that, like the way you describe it. You know, it's a creature with wings, so we know it's got wings. A cupid or cherub, that gives me an image in my head. Seems harmless. But then we've got this shriek, which uses our hearing. And we've got revealing rows of sharp teeth. I bolted away from it, which, you know, showing us that this is very dangerous, not telling us it's dangerous, that's great. I bolted away from it into a crevice in the wall, which I could barely fit in. Then I spied what I hoped was an exit. It was behind the creature. I darted towards the pedestal, picking up the heart. The monster dived towards me, teeth bared, ready to attack. I ducked under it and took off towards the exit, pulling on the ivy, leaving it to crumble behind me, cutting off the creature from following me. I was safe, hopefully. Cool. I reckon, from following me, I would have an extra sentence where like I could hear scratching or something on the other side. Get another sense in there. Get another kind of moment of description to kind of have what's taking place around us. And then have I was safe. Hopefully. That's cool. These are great. All of these are really engaging and exciting and are really vivid. But what I really like about these compared to some of the things we've written in the past is we have a narrative that is going from start to finish, right? Like we can see how it's moving. When you're writing descriptively, particularly if you're going to go an exam, a couple of you guys have tried to go for like time jumps, that we've gone back in time, or you've kind of gone for like quite complex plots. You don't need to do that. You can just have a really clear beginning, middle and end. You're exploring, you find what you look, and then you kind of run and have to get away. I think for a lot of questions you get asked, that's probably a narrative like pattern you can fit. So what I'd like you to do is this. What you've written here, feel free to kind of work it up into a story. Maybe give it a second edit, see how it looks. If you send anything over to me, I get a fair few things at the moment from students. So if you do want to send over me what you got, it might take me a couple of days to get back to you. But your parents or teachers or carers can send what you've written to me at mark@markgrease.com or send it here as well. If you want to have a go at writing your own next stage of this, how do you escape the jungle? Like what? Maybe something's waiting for you outside the jungle. What can happen next? Where do you want to take it next? I would say if you want to give yourself a challenge, see if you can write an additional 200 words at the end of this. Right? What would you do next? And I'd love to see what you can come up with from that. How can you use all the skills that you've used so far? Anything you send to me, I will mark, I will look through. But otherwise, guys, I know it's been an absolute nightmare at times today, sessions with the tech. But let me just say, I have been so impressed with every single one of you, and you really have done so well. If you can keep thinking about descriptive writing in the way that you've been doing with me, you will do great. You do brilliantly when you go back to school. You've done really, really well. So everyone, Lucy, well done for today. Darren, well done. Adam, absolute star. Well done. Jack, such a star. Really good to have you back today. Well done. Ophelia, I loved reading your work all the way through this. Next week, I will be back for my final session. It's at 9:30. You guys are very welcome. I'm inviting everyone from Key Stage 3 and 4 together. We'll do some activities together, and I will we'll have a chat about how we're going back to school and what we're going to do. You are very welcome to be there, and I would love to see you. But this is the very last session together. And do you know what? You've really impressed me. Well done. Those pieces of descriptive writing were ace from start to bottom. If you get any of them written up with the extra 200 words, send them over. But otherwise, guys, it's been an absolute treat to work with you today. Thank you very much. I hope you have a great day. All right. See you guys later on. And if you are there for 9:30 next week, I would love to see you. But yeah, it's been an absolute blast. Well done. Bye-bye.